parents were messaging me saying, we're watching The Masked Singer. My three-year-old wasn't even watching it, heard you sing and went, oh, that's Simon. So the guessing panel couldn't figure it out, but three-year-olds could.
With performances that were anything but wooden, let's give a hand to Puppet, the mask who proved they were certainly no dummy on stage.
Lord Almighty, I feel my temperature rising.
There he is, the puppet, the scariest creature on television in 2020. You've terrified a lot of people, but also you've brought a lot of joy. Simon Price, congratulations. Well done, mate.
Yeah, thank you, Millsy. Look, I had an absolute blast. It was so much fun. I didn't realise I was going to be so scary. And that people would think I was so scary. It's not normally in my job description to scare people. Normally, I'm trying to, you know, be light and fun and playful.
How did it work? Are you controlling the eyes and the mouth and...
No. So somebody else, it's a remote control and they're controlling the eyes and the mouth separately and trying to match what I'm doing. The funny thing was my viewpoint was through the mouth and I could see about 2 meters in front of me on the floor, this little section. But every time the mouth closed, I couldn't see. So every time I was doing something and they closed the mouth.
As far as being restrictive, I thought you, especially in that last song, you were doing like kung fu moves. It could have been Ricky Martin in the costume.
I think my hips are a little bit more welded than Ricky's, but yeah. Got a new addiction for
every day and night. Was it fun to be able to, you know, try out some pop songs and try out something different?
Yeah, totally. I mean, I would never in a million years ever attempt to sing any of those songs, ever. Maybe nobody ever wants to hear them again, but I had a good time doing it at the time.
What was your favourite song?
I think the most challenging and probably the one and the most rewarding in the end was Despacito, because I had to learn Spanish. Despacito. And I apologise actually for my Spanish because it was terrible, but I had to learn Spanish and commit it all to memory. And you know what it's like. You actually kind of think with this show, you sing a song, you have a bit of time to learn another song. I mean, you're just learning these songs back to back all at once in advance just in case you get through the next rounds. But also Take On Me, Aha. That was a lot of fun to do. That was great. Talking away, I don't know what I'm to say, I'll say it anyway.
Today's another day to find you. I want to know, who do you think will take home the Masked Singer trophy for 2020?
Look, it is hard to know because everybody is so different. And I think that's the beauty of what this show is as well, as everybody comes from such different backgrounds, whether you're a singer or not. I think out of the three that are left, which they all are also different, I love Bushranger's voice. So I think it's got a lot of soul to it. It's a great sound. So, yeah, the other two, amazing. Everyone's amazing. But I'm tipping Bushranger for the win, I reckon. She got a hold on me.
She got me wrapped around her finger. Now, the guest's job is to come up with names, come up with people who they think that you could be. Were you happy at some of the guesses that they made about you?
You know, the happiest guest for me with my background in music theatre was Anthony Warlow. Now, Anthony might not be very happy about that. The other random one I got, I think from Husey, seems to pull a few out of there, was Anthony Hopkins, and Will Smith was another one, but... Well, yeah, maybe not. But yeah, Anthony Warlow, I'll take that one any day.
The reveal itself, when you have to take the mask off, what was that feeling like for you? Was it like relief that you finally revealed this is who I am?
Look, I think it was a bit of relief. I think I was kind of, I was loving every moment of it, but I was also happy to have this experience and to get the puppet head off and to show the guessing panel of who I am and everything. It was a touch... sadness, because you want to keep going in it because you're having so much fun, but also a lot of relief as well, just to take the head off and say hi to everyone.
How did you go with the lying? Because you're one of the nicest people that I know, Simon.
I felt terrible. I didn't want to lie to anyone, so I just didn't reply to anyone. So what's really funny is that parents were messaging me saying, we're watching The Masked Singer. My three-year-old wasn't even watching it, heard you sing and went, oh, that's Simon. So the guessing panel couldn't figure it out, but three-year-olds could.
Congratulations. Thanks so much for being part of The Masked Singer. You definitely made a huge impact on myself, on Danny, that's for sure, and on everyone. So, mate, thanks so much.
Thank you, Millsy. Great to talk to you, mate. We'll see you again soon.